Hey guys, we're gonna be reading more Rainbow Six Siege Conqueror of the Sea for more strength alive! So, here we go. The helicopter ride from the Rome up to England was a bit bumpy, but not bad. Once the helicopter landed... Once the helicopter landed on the designated spot, stop it back door to pull Red's old seemingly still intact airbase, which Six told me was called Hereford. After a short walk, we came to a door to which Six left the car near a scanner, allowing us to go inside. Oh yeah, I don't sweat that. Come on, the others are, Six said, and I followed him, and for a while, a little bit, and saw two recruits walk towards two doors that once opened to reveal a large cafeteria with a bunch of people sitting at tables, seemingly having breakfast, but that all came to an end when Six raised his voice to enough that they got new operators, which everyone looked at him before looking at me. While looking at their faces, I saw some had pure terror in their eyes, while others looked and talked amongst themselves and whispered, but within a large muscular man, with a bow of Vakalva covering his voice, walked right up to me and held out his hand, which I shook, but that wasn't all, this man told me. His name was Alexander. I quickly hugged him too, which he responded, "It's good to see you too, Alexei." And also historically, you spelled Alexander wrong. You forgot an E. I don't even know how to spell that. Whatever. After I put him down, and you didn't even capitalize after it. Come on, historical. After I put him down, and he called over some of his friends, and they greeted me, which seemed to put everyone at ease. Alexander invited me over to his table, to which we caught up and on old times. As we were talking, I felt two slender arms wrapped around me and a familiar voice made me look over my shoulder to see Sana, who smiled before I kissed my head and walking away. Oh my goodness, it's so funny to work on your grammar. This is a poor. What was that all about? That's Maxim, which I told him. It's a long story that I'll tell you someday. But before we both clumped, making other people at the table chuckle for a moment, so I felt the balls come to my right pocket. When I pulled out my phone to see the text of Sophia saying that both of her and Ella were being called back to the base in a couple of weeks, due to what happened a day or two ago, and that they were bringing the weapons I used during the siege of Hereford. After everyone got breakfast, we were all dismissed. As people were leaving the cafeteria, Six walked up to me and told me to follow him thereafter. He directed me to his office. Sometimes later, he assigned me to a pool that was reserved for me, to which he showed me, and it was pretty nice, with a pair of TVs sitting on a table with some DVD players on its shelf. On the left side of the room, and the right side had larger and deeper pools than the one in the Grimm's headquarters. Well, I'll let you get acquainted with your room, Six said before walking out the door. But stop to tell me that I was expected in the workshop, as a person named Mara is expecting me for some reasons. I asked him where it was about. It was, but all he did was point me at my phone and left. After my little explosion around the room, my phone went off with an alert that repeated with 6KB. But when I asked where it was, this place, a 3D map was viewed with a red dot. Using the phone was no problem as I found the place with ease. With its help, I opened the door to reveal the room. Walkers. Everyone stripped. No, that never happened. I wish it did. That had the code names and symbols of other operators in the building. I noticed one locker which has a fear and error. That was larger than the rest of it, the code name Power. On it, followed a symbol of a stretched head split down the middle, with the colors being opposite of each other. Soon, I see or heard a large crack from behind me, followed by some Spanish screaming. I quickly followed the source and found a small strip before turning around, dropping them again, surprised. "Who the hell are you?" She had said rather calmly before I said my name. "Oh, it's you," she said before directing my attention to the metal on the floor. "What's that all that for?" I asked which bird or fire it said. "Well, this is something I was working on in my spare time, but now I have to start all over again." Her own frustration, her frown and frustration told me that she needed some help on this project. So in my deep voice, I asked, "Do you need any help?" Which she gratefully accepted. After a while, we finally got it done, which made Mara sign relief and something in Spanish. "Well, it looks like that's done," I said, which made Mara chuckle before realizing why I was here. "Oh, I almost forgot your gadget," Mara said before running over to a red box opening to reveal some black armor that was made for one of the persons, and the person is me. "This armor is made for titanium mixed with iron to give off that defensive look." She said while I was examining the armor more closely before picking up the box, walking up to my locker, and pushing it for whatever tomorrow may hold. After that, I told Mary goodbye and left for my dorm. Once I got to my dorm, I took out the piece of paper that was in my back pocket to reveal Ella phone number with some writing at the bottom that said "see you soon," followed by XOX, so they're gay. So I turned on my phone, typed my password in, and put Ella's phone number in. And also, this is too much information, people already know how that works. After I did that, I noticed to another phone number that belonged to Santa and Zofia. Some of these sexy pictures of them. I put out the phone on the table in front of the TV stand where I sat on a chair, grabbed the TV remote, and watched some TVs. After an hour or so, my phone went off with a text from Santa. And that is the end, my friends, of Rainbow Six Conqueror of the Sea by Horror Historian 45. And also, stay tuned for the next reading in a couple of minutes. Hiya!
That was freaking gay. I rate that a 0 out of 10. That had to be one of the
strangest things I ever heard.
Figure this way, you need to work on grammar. Like, that was bad. That was so bad. Literally, he missed so much commas and periods and so much capitalization. It is bad.
Oh, well, it gets better. Trust
yeah, I know how you feel, Samuel, because I have hard times reading it because it's so bad. Because I'll be like, and then he went to this, so and much. Then.
It sounded like it.
And then he went down the road.
Oh, yeah, and I just started being like.
Okay, well, good job. Actually, not really.